This is Marketing Jam, a show featuring the brightest minds in marketing.
Brought to you by Canada Post. Head to canadapost.ca/insightpodcast for ideas to add value to your marketing.
Welcome to another episode of Marketing Jam. I'm so excited because we have Victor here with Fresh Prep. Yep. Not to be confused with all the other freshes and meal delivery services that are out there. Give us some of the names of the other ones that are out there.
Miss Fresh, Hello Fresh, Good Food, Chef's Play, and I'm in Blue Apron in the States. Yeah. Everything's out there.
Yeah, so speaking of Blue Apron, so the origin story is how I got into food delivery services was Blue Apron. So listening to Malcolm Gladwell's podcast, Revisionist History, he kept talking about Blue Apron, and I was like, what is this Blue Apron? It sounds amazing. I want to try this. Yeah. And so I Googled it, and then being Googling from Canada, it told me about my options in Canada, and then I got turned on to your services.
Cool. Yeah. Have you enjoyed them so far?
I've loved it. So I'm a parent. My wife and I, we've got now 4 children, and I love to cook. So it's almost like they provided for me a food prep person in my life that I can come home to. And I have a 12-year-old as well, so we can actually do the meal together.
Yeah.
Have some fun with it. It takes away the stress of all that. And also, it introduced me to so many new vegetables and foods that I would have never thought of. Even I made poutine one night at home. It was the coolest thing in the world.
You're selling it better than I could.
No, I just love the convenience, but more so it stretched my thinking. Like I think I would get in such a rut of like what meals to cook and what spices to use, which vegetables to use. And so it just really opened my eyes to a really cool world.
Yeah.
But let's talk about you. How did you get to where you are today?
So before I even joined Fresh Prep, I was a customer first. Gave the service a shot. And then shortly afterwards, somebody from Fresh Prep actually reached out to me. Seeing I was interested in a job. Part of that, I was at Bench leading their marketing. And part of that, I was consulting in Hong Kong. And then part of that, I was working for a FTSE 100 doing marketing. So it's been marketing all the way. But I've really enjoyed Fresh Prep.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
So for you, as a marketer, someone doing marketing, this opportunity for people to get to partake in your service and your offering, do you call it a service or do you call it a product? And what you're doing?
It's a bit of both. For a lot of our competitors, I would say it's just a product. But ours, I would say it's a service and a product. And the reason behind that is we actually do all of our deliveries. We're based out of Vancouver, so we're local to anybody in BC. We have our own fleet of delivery drivers who actually drives out every single meal kit to your doorsteps, drops it off at your doorsteps, and manages that process. If you're using Chef's Plate or HelloFresh from the competitors, if you give them a shot, you probably notice that they come via UPS or Canada Post or FedEx. And the horrible thing about that is when you call into the customer service and say, hey, where's my delivery? They'll say, here's a UPS tracking number. Go find out where it is on your own. But with us, we employ our own fleet of drivers so we can say, your place, sorry, your kit is exactly in Abbotsford in this cross street. It'll be arrived at your doorsteps in 5 minutes.
Wow.
So it's a service and a product.
Wow. Have you gone to like the warehouse where everyone's prepping everything and cutting and slicing and dicing?
Yeah, and I've done all of that too. Okay. It's really good because within the company, we do get the opportunity to try doing some of everything.
Yeah.
So I have given that a shot, and it's fun. It's good seeing and good understanding the process behind all of it too.
So I've always wondered, we also get food delivery from Save On Foods, Overweighty. I'm curious why you think they've never got in on the meal delivery kit business.
Honestly, after working in mostly SaaS and software business for a while, I've realized that the meal kit industry, it's like rocket science. There's so much that you have to know and do. A lot of prep work. We cut up all of our different vegetables that don't require any additional preservative behind it, just so that you don't need to do that when you get home. It's all ready to cook. You just have it poured out there. I think with the Save-Ons and everything else, they don't have the operations and logistics to manage doing that. But because we have that and it's all ready for you to prepare and cook, it's the convenience factor that we sell.
I do love that you have the meal kits that like some are real short minutes, like 5 to 10 minute kits that are all super prepped. But there are still some that are longer, like 30 to 40 minutes where I'm still feeling like I'm part of the process. And sometimes I can take out the spices or add more spices.
So you're going to be the chef. It's convenient, and you know exactly how spicy you want it as well.
Okay. Now, for you, what are you seeing as far as trends for acquiring customers? Like, is it postage? Is it SEO when people are Google searching? Like, where are you seeing you're getting your conversions from?
It's a mix of everything. We do everything from events to direct mail to Facebook ads, Google ads, SEO, everything, even business development. It's a mix. We find most of our customers come in organically and through referrals. with our program right now, we do a referral benefit yep. where when you refer a friend, you get a free meal and your friend gets a free meal, mm-hmm. Addition to what they normally get. So mm-hmm. it's a good way of getting a good word of mouth out there.
Okay. So almost like not like a pyramid scheme, but it's
affiliate.
Affiliate, yeah. Yes. But they get one meal out of the deal, which is yeah. incentive enough. Mm-hmm. Or just because they love it so much, they're willing yeah. to tell their friends about it.
Yeah, we do see that quite a bit.
Okay. And so who are you marketing to? Like, have you figured out your exact demo that you want?
Yeah,
that loves the kits?
It's a really interesting distribution because we see a bit of a curve like that for mm-hmm. our age distribution. Mm-hmm. Usually people around yourself, younger mm-hmm. professionals, mm-hmm. Family with kids. They just want to cook good food for their family mm-hmm. and they want it to be fast and convenient. Yeah. They don't want to go out grocery shopping when it's raining outside, mm-hmm. carrying all these bags. They want all the groceries straight to the doorsteps. Mm-hmm. So it's great for busy people like yourself.
Yeah.
And then for people who are older who just can't get out that easily. Yeah. They can follow the easy instructions that we have and cook yeah. the food. Yeah. So it works on those both ends.
Yeah. I've always wondered, and I don't know if you guys have this yeah. in development, the day when the meal delivery kits will come with wine pairing suggestions and then yes. you could add the wine to go with it. Have you guys looked at that or is it an option?
We have looked into that, but the difficult thing around the liquor laws is if we're delivering liquor, you have to be present at the door to pick it up. Mm. Make sure that you're of legal drinking yeah. age and everything else.
Okay.
We do have add-ons though for other products though. So now you can buy cookie dough or cookies or extra protein with your kit.
Oh, nice. Mm-hmm. So if you want to up your protein game.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. The other thought I had was I use this app. Under Armour has an app, so it tracks all your nutritional bits and pieces.
Fitness Pal.
It's amazing. Yeah.
It's great.
And so I thought it'd be cool to tap that in into one of these meal delivery things, and then they could suggest meals for me to make sure that my macros are level.
Yeah, yeah. We've thought about that. We're not at that stage right now, but it's on the roadmap.
Okay. Yeah. I have liked it when I've logged in and put in certain meal delivery things, like menu, and it's been in there, which has been really nice. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Normally what I do with MyFitnessPal is I'll just put in the calorie count within the recipe cards that we can deliver, just so I can keep track of that.
No, that's cool. Yeah. Now, what do you go to, like, do you read, do you podcast, where do you go to kind of keep inspired when it comes to marketing? And
a few different ways. I also teach at UBC, mm-hmm. at Startup School of Business. I teach digital marketing there to the undergrads, mm-hmm. MBAs, and to their Sales and Marketing Executive International Program. Mm-hmm. And being part of that, it gives me access to world-class faculty that keeps mm-hmm. publishing new papers about consumer behavior, data analytics, and everything else. So on that side, I have the academic side covered. Wow. I really enjoy that.
Cool.
But from a lot of the industry side, I like reading things like Social Media Examiner, Occam's Razor, Avinash Kaushik's blog. A lot of those type of blogs.
That's really cool. Mm-hmm. Now, the academic papers, can everyday people get access to those?
Quite a few of them get released. And the great thing about that is if you go to Harvard Business Review mm-hmm. or Forbes, quite often they'll actually cite these papers in their studies. So you don't need to read through everything about like the one-way ANOVAs and whatever type of statistics they use, the regression analysis for it. It's just in plain English.
That is really cool.
Yeah.
And what about you? Are you Android or iOS guy?
iOS.
Okay, and apps that you can't live without on a daily basis?
Oh my goodness. It sounds crazy and a bit stalkerish, but Find Friends.
Yes? Do you have a group of friends or family that you...
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Friends and family are always like, oh, where are you? How do I find you?
Yeah. Cool.
Yourself?
I love Google Maps.
Yeah.
The texting app. I'm actually on a bit of a break from Instagram. I'm taking an Instagram hiatus for a period right now. But normally I'd be on Instagram and loved it.
Yeah.
But the weather app, I started getting more into it just because I've been traveling and trying to figure out what to pack.
I love the weather app too, but it's never really spot on, I find. It's always it's going to be sunny and then it's rainy. Or maybe it's Vancouver, not the app.
Yeah.
Probably Vancouver.
True. Yeah, all of our microclimates that we have here. And other apps that you were in love with or that you...
I try not to use my phone too much, honestly.
Okay.
You know, I'm always scared of being addicted to it, but I do read Reddit every now and then as well.
What do you like about Reddit?
Just the very bite-sized headlines, and if you want more information, just click it for the full article.
Yeah.
And you can get information about anything there.
Yeah. Have you joined in any conversations about meal delivery kits?
I've seen quite a few of them. And the interesting thing is when I look at the ones about the BC or Vancouver specific ones, at the end of it, it's usually Fresh Prep is the winner. It's like you read through all the comments that talk about Chef's Plate, HelloFresh, and the ones they've tried, and then it's always like, but Fresh Prep is the best.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. That must be encouraging.
It's super encouraging.
Do you ever pipe in there or say anything?
No, I don't. It's all completely organic.
And
even when I go on Facebook, I look at reviews and everything.
Yeah.
We have the best reviews. I believe we're at 4.5 roughly stars out of 5 on Facebook.
Yeah.
I think our competitor, Good Food, was at 3.74 time period, and HelloFresh as well. But now, HelloFresh, Good Food, and Chef's Plate, all the reviews are disabled. There's no star rating anymore.
Oh, they realize it's...
So I think they realize that, you know, they're all below where we're at. So, I mean, why even bother? Just disable all of it.
And the hard thing would be, too, is that the reviews are going to be not just about the food, but it's about the delivery, the user experience on, you know, ordering. And
So we're really, really just thankful for all the great customers that we have who've really been supporting us and been saying wonderful things about us as well.
What do you see next steps as far as marketing or promotions for your brand?
Next step, not so much marketing promotions, but on the product side,
we're
looking to go completely zero waste.
Okay.
So what I actually have over here with me is this this new cooler bag. So people listening on the podcast, they can't see this, but this is our new zero waste cooler bag.
Okay, and is it different than the other bags that are out there?
It is slightly different, So we're gonna have in the future is a tray that fits in perfectly into here with all of all of our different ingredients and recipes. So instead of it being just one big thing, it's going to be made ready. So it's no single-use plastic. It's all just a zero-waste kit.
So what would the trays be made of?
I don't know the exact material there. I have to ask the engineers for that. But it is a reusable container. Think almost like a Ziploc container.
Wow. That's really cool.
Yeah.
And then ice will fit inside there, or ice blocks.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I mean, right now we're ready the most sustainable meal kit out there because for any single-use plastic that we deliver, if you rinse it out, we'll recycle it for you.
If you put it back in the bag.
Exactly, yeah.
And then people put it back in the bag, put it on their front door, and then you guys pick it up.
We pick up everything, recycle it. And none of our competitors can do that because they deliver everything in these giant cardboard boxes.
Yes, yes.
Once you're done with it, it's your job to get rid of the waste.
Yeah.
Because they don't have drivers to pick it up for you. They use UPS or Canada Post.
Yeah.
But because we do that, we're the most sustainable meal kit out there. But we're still looking at becoming even more sustainable.
Wow. And do you think that's going to give you a competitive edge? Do you think people care about that enough to pick you over the others?
I think they do care about that, but the reality behind it is we're not just doing this for the competitive differentiator.
No.
We're doing this because we actually believe it's what's best.
Wow.
So if you think about the fact that we drive out all of our meal kits to our different customers' doorsteps, what that does, it actually increases the cost for us. But at the end of the day, this is better for us as a whole because one, we can recycle things for our customers, so it's better for the planet. And two, we can help the local economy by hiring drivers locally so that they have jobs to do this.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, we're looking at what's best for both the people and the planet. And this is indicative in our B Corp certification.
Yeah.
Are you familiar with B Corp?
Yeah, we're a fellow B Corp as well.
Oh, great. That's awesome. Yeah. We're the only only meal kit that's B Corp certified in the world.
Oh, that's really
and if we look at some of the other B Corps out there, Good Foods was B Corp certified, but they lost their certification. So we're constantly looking at ways to be the best that we possibly can be for people on the planet, not just for our business.
Yeah. And then soon we got Ben & Jerry's.
Patagonia.
Right. There's some incredible organizations
there.
We've interviewed a few B Corps actually on the show. So Coast Capital Savings will be one of the shows.
Very cool.
Now, as far as the kit is concerned, when people order it and the options that they have, what makes the options they have unique compared to the others?
We have 10 weekly options, and when we look at the price per serving for us versus our competitors, we are on the more economical side, despite the fact that we have all these added services to our product. We also offer meals that are free of gluten or dairy, as well as a vegan vegetarian options. So a lot of our competitors don't do that. We try to cater to any single diet out there.
Yeah. And are you finding that like partnerships with like other brands or celebrity chefs jumping in, does that give you a nice boost or does that help at all or is it?
Well, I mean, we are a local brand that's a bit smaller. We don't have big pockets like HelloFresh.
Yeah.
It's based out of Berlin. They've got, I think, millions to spend right now. We want to be a bit more lean with things. So for us, it's really through a lot of our customers who are supporting and promoting us that helps us get our word out across. It's not so much the big celebrity chefs out there. It's just people know what's best, the best service, the best product, and they've been enjoying us.
That's really cool. And lunch and dinner options, right? Any breakfast at the moment?
We have a few. So it's primarily dinner, but because our servings are so large, a lot of people will take this for breakfast the next day or for lunch as well.
Yeah.
I mean, anybody who's looking to purchase add-ons, a lot of our competitors don't allow for this add-on purchase of extra protein or extra cookies or whatever.
Yeah.
So we also do sell breakfast cookies, and soon we'll have kid meals out there in September.
That's really cool.
Yeah. It's great for your family.
Yeah, no, it's awesome. So as a teacher as well, you know, in the position that you're in now, if you were to talk to students, and maybe students or people that are excited about, you know, growing in their digital marketing or marketing endeavors, what was the biggest advice you give to someone to get in the position where you are today?
Never stop learning. Always have that hunger and ambition. There's so many great free certifications out there that I would highly recommend, like the Google Analytics individual qualification,
yep.
Google AdWords certifications, or Google Ads now it's called,
yeah.
and Facebook Ads, it's a Facebook Blueprint program, I think it's called. Yeah. A lot of free resources online.
Yeah. Yeah, and I think with Blueprint and Hootsuite, there's a couple exams that you pay to do, but the teaching is free.
Exactly.
Which is really cool.
And I mean, I think for all the Google ones, they're all free.
They're all free. Yeah, which is really amazing.
Yeah.
SEMrush is also another free one online.
Yeah.
So what about for you as far as kind of next steps for your own learning, and where do you go? Is there conferences or events? Is there, you know, something that you'd recommend that someone does?
Yeah, I mean, I always say find a good mentor out there as well.
Hmm.
So for myself, there's some people that I meet with on a monthly or quarterly basis, and it really helps me to just keep the creative juices flowing as well.
Cool.
Conferences, I haven't been to too many lately, but I used to always attend ClickZ.
Okay.
It's a pretty good one, and they have them all around the world, I believe.
Yeah.
I know they have a bunch of different locations in North America, too.
Totally.
Yeah, those are enjoyable.
And then, so do you end up doing getting your work internal, or do you guys use vendors, or do you outsource any of your marketing?
Bit of a mix. So for some of our digital ads, we'll outsource part of it.
Yeah.
But a lot of it we do all in-house.
Which is really cool.
Yeah.
When do you find the difference? How do you know when to outsource and when to keep it in-house?
I think when the service level starts to go down because you decide to outsource it is when it happens. An example of this is, if you ever attend any of the events that our competitors at and ask them about the product or service, you can ask them about it. They'll tell you everything about it. You go back an hour and there's a different brand ambassador out there. You ask them about the same questions. They'll give you different answers. So I've heard things like one of our competitors saying that they recycle everything for them and that Amazon delivers for them and that all these different things. Yeah. Then you go back and you ask the next person and it's completely different answers.
Yeah.
So for ourselves, for all our events, we have our own in-house team of brand ambassadors who does this. So because we want to make sure that what we do is truthful and good and honest.
Yeah, okay. And what about for like Google AdWords buying and kind of analytics, analysis? Do you guys do that
mostly in-house, yeah.
Okay, that's really cool. And as far as being in Vancouver, what makes Vancouver special, unique to running a company like yours?
Ooh, that's a great question. I think with Vancouverites, people in the Lower Mainland, even BC in general, the eating habits are quite different than other parts of the other provinces.
Mm-hmm.
So we try to cater to everybody who's the active yoga lifestyle, to the family person, to the person who's just looking for quick and convenient.
Yeah.
And we have personas built for each of these as well.
That's amazing. Have you ever seen the video by John Crist about meal delivery programs?
Have not.
So he does a spoof on it saying it's a meal delivery program that you can buy. So your neighbors and everyone thinks you're getting these really, you know, healthy artisanal meals that you're going to make yourself, but inside it's fast food. So it's like Burger King and Taco Bell and KFC.
Nice. I haven't seen them. I got to check that one out.
Yeah. It's for people that don't want to have to cook a meal, but they still want to look cool to their neighbors. Yeah. No, it's pretty awesome. I'll send you a link to that.
Yeah, no, I'd love to see that.
Anything else that you want to leave listeners and viewers about the work that you're doing and kind of marketing in general?
Marketing in general? Mm-hmm. Not too much that I don't want to leave behind aside from that. Yeah. No, I just really enjoy chatting and talking about marketing.
So teaching-wise, what are you most excited about maybe coming up this semester that you want to teach these students? Like, what's something that they need to hear that you're like, if I could teach one class, this is what I'd put in that class?
I think it's tough to do that just because the breadth of marketing is all over the place.
Yeah.
Like we have data and business intelligence, we have brand, we have PR and communications. Yeah. There isn't so much as one thing that you really need to learn to be a good marketer.
Yeah.
It's everything you need to know at least a little bit about.
Yeah.
Because at some point in your career, if you do want to go further in marketing, you will come across a bridge where it's, hey, you're being interviewed. Do you know enough about PR or communications to actually manage it? Or, hey, you're given a spreadsheet full of the different data points. Can you actually synthesize this data and turn it to information? There's just so many different touch points for marketing as a whole.
But I like that you touched on certifications and the importance of it, because then if they leave whatever school they're at, UBC Sauder, SFU, BCIT, if there's an external body saying that they know what they're talking about and they've gone through the exam, they've gotten certified, then anywhere they go, they can prove that they know what they're saying.
Exactly. Yeah. And it's great for new grads because it helps differentiate them from the other grads that don't have these certifications, right? Everybody's going to have a degree, but you have a degree and a certification.
So as a prof, how do you kind of bake that into your class, or how do you point students to those?
We go through some of the general learnings from the different certifications, but we don't go too far in depth with them. UBC is pretty good at differentiating themselves from something like BCIT, a technical school. UBC is not just the academic practice, but the theory and incorporating this in industry as well. So it's balancing those parts through the teaching curriculum.
Okay. And so you can mention them, but maybe it's students, you can tell who has initiative, who's a little more chill.
That's right, yeah.
Okay, and those that have initiative, go and grab them.
Yeah.
So you can just point, but you can't make them do it, or you can't make it part of the syllabus.
No, technically I could, but there's just so many different things I have to cover as well, because with the undergrad course, for example, it's 13 weeks, the MBA course is 5 weeks.
Yeah.
That really isn't enough time to go through entire certification.
Yeah. Right? They got to do it in their own time, their own initiative.
Yeah.
But it'll really make them stand out to get hired.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. A few of my former students have actually done these certifications, and getting them a job afterwards, like I can refer them to different agencies and they get picked up immediately.
Because you can say, because then if you refer them, it's not like, oh yeah, they know this great theory. You can actually say they know the theory and they've gone through the practice of doing the exams.
Yeah, and they really enjoy it. It's really worth it.
Okay. Yeah. Anything else as far as like listeners, viewers, how do they know which one to go with, which kit? When they're Google searching it and they're looking at all the options, what should they really be looking for?
In terms of meal kits?
Yeah, like how do they, what filter should they be using? I know you're biased, but what's a good filter, would you say?
What's a good filter? Well, honestly, I would take the approach that you mentioned earlier. Just try all of them.
Okay.
Try all of them and then decide for yourself which one is the best.
Yeah. Off camera, off video, I mentioned I tried every single meal kit for a week or so just to see what one I liked the most. So yeah.
Yeah, and I mean, for people in BC specifically, I subjectively, we'll definitely recommend Fresh Prep because we're based out of Vancouver. You're not getting food that's made or produced within Berlin, since it's where HelloFresh is, or in the East Coast, or sent out over here one day at Canada Post before it gets sent out again. Like we do it in a facility here in Vancouver, and it gets out to you. Like,
and your B Corp.
And our B Corp.
Those that don't know what B Corp is, why don't you explain B Corp?
B Corp is a global certification from B Labs. They have offices all around the world, and essentially it's a certification for businesses that are sustainable in practice, have good practice for both the people and the planet, and there's a certain threshold of points you have to receive before you're B Corp certified. Am I missing anything? I can't remember everything with B Corp.
No, that's great.
Pretty good. Okay.
Yeah, it's like a filter to say, are they using their business as a force for good?
Perfect. Yeah. That's a bit better.
Yeah, and it holds us accountable to maintaining our point level. And you know, we had to show them all sorts of stuff, man. We had to lift up that hood, and they looked at everything, like also our structure, our hiring, our everything.
Yeah.
It's pretty amazing.
I started Fresh Prep about 2 years ago, and at before I even started, they were going through the certification process.
Yeah,
I think it took over a year to get that certification, so it's pretty rigorous.
Yeah. Well, that's awesome. Well, thank you for joining us on the show, viewers, listeners. So those that are in which provinces can they get Fresh Prep?
BC specifically.
So only BC.
We're looking to expand, but right now it's just BC.
Just BC. So BC listeners, Ontario folks, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
You know, I guess you have to use the other options.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
BC listeners, viewers, Fresh Prep, it's awesome. There may be some notes. Check out. There might be a coupon code we might get out of this, which would be awesome, and you could try it, right? And you guys offer some pretty cool trial deals or whatever.
Yeah, I'll pass over a coupon code for 3 free meals in your first trial.
3 free meals?
Yeah.
3 free meals. Okay, so you're just going to give us 3 free meals.
3 free meals.
Okay,
that's it.
Which is awesome. And we'll see you next time on Marketing Jam. Thank you so much.